Competition is prevalent in almost any business. It is very important to be unique from your competition and offer something better than your competition to stay in the market and to stay for a long time. In this video, let us see a few ways to beat the competition and how to overcome competition. Basically, we will be seeing about three ways in which you can overcome competition. Number one is a strategy where your product is offered at a low cost, but at the same time, your product is sold to numerous customers. That is low cost, high volume. Let us see what it is. You will see what it is with an example, how to achieve it, what are the prerequisites, and what are the advantages and risks involved in adopting the low-cost, high-volume strategy. So, what is low-cost, high-volume strategy? Low-cost, high-volume strategy is offering your product at the lowest price. That is, among the products that are available in the market to satisfy a particular need of your target audience, your product will be the lowest in terms of price. No other product will be even nearer to your product in terms of pricing. At the same time, you will be aiming to sell your product to huge number of customers. That is, you will be aiming to make huge volume of sales. That is low cost, high volume strategy. So, to see an example, we can take Amul ice creams. Amul ice creams have very good taste and they are known for its quality and tasty ice creams. However, when you see the price of Amul ice creams, it is very lesser than when compared to other brands like quality. Amul has adopted this low cost, high volume strategy. That is why they were able to reach huge volume of sales at the same time maintaining the standard of good taste. Okay, how to achieve this low cost, high volume strategy? Basically, to achieve this, you should cover a large number of customers, as I said earlier. Second, during production, your production should attain economics of scale. What is economics of scale? As your volume of production goes up, the cost for producing becomes lower. As the quantity of products produced goes up, the cost for producing those quantity comes down. This is called economics of scale. So, as you sell a huge volume of products, your actual cost comes down. So, if you are able to achieve this, you can follow low cost, high volume strategy. Third is high level of standardization. What is high level of standardization? When there is a standardization in the market among the products that are there to satisfy a particular need, it means all the products will be of same future, will have same futures, will solve the same problem. So, there are may not be major differences between the products. It will be same in terms of all the futures, all the problems that it is solving. So, there will not be any differentiation among the various products available in the market. And you should invest in technology that helps in reducing your production cost. If you are in service industry, maybe you can use automation, lot of automation tools that are available to minimize the overall cost. Finally, there should not be any differentiation among your product and the competitive products. All the products should be of same standard. Only then you can differentiate from other products in terms of pricing. Here we are aiming at a low cost. Rest of the things will be same as the competition. Only thing that will be different from your product and competitor's product is the cost of the product. So you should not try to make any differentiation in terms of product features or product offering. In that case, your product may move to a different market segment, and there may not be a standardization across the products available in the market. So you should not try any differentiation techniques while you are trying to achieve low cost, high volume. And what are the prerequisites to achieve this low cost, high volume? The markup should be very price sensitive, which means even a slight increase in price of a particular product should make the customer to move to a competitor's product, which is at a lower cost. Since there is no major differentiation among the various products available in the market, customers need not worry about the product features of different brands that are offering the product. Their only concern will be the price. So when there is a price sensitive market, you can aim for low cost, high volume strategy. And as we saw earlier, differentiation is not important because standardization is important. The product should have same standard across all the competitors' products. Then, when buyers have high bargaining power, this low cost strategy will definitely help. Since all the products are of same standard as same features, customers tend to bargain. And since there are a lot of options available, customer has a higher bargaining power. When you offer the product at lower cost than your competitor's product, which has the same features and benefits, the customers may tend to buy it without any bargaining. And you can follow this low cost, high volume strategy in a market where there is low customer loyalty. Since there is no major difference between the products available in the market, customers can easily switch from one brand to another brand or one product to another product. And when the cost of switching between seller is low, it is very easy to follow the strategy. What is cost of switching between sellers? Let us say you are seeking an internet service connection and you are going for a particular brand, and the brand says you have to buy this modem and router apart from the service connection. So you pay some money and buy the router and modem. And after a few months, you are not satisfied with the service provided and you want to switch to another brand. But what happens is the another brand wants to have a separate router and modem. Already you have invested in the router and modem when you first purchased the internet connection. You cannot use the existing router and modem to the internet service connection of the second player. In this case, the cost of router and modem will be a waste for you. So there is a switching cost. You may think to invest again in a router and modem. So this is called switching cost. So when the cost of switching is low in the market, it is wise to adopt this low cost, high volume strategy. Now let us see what are the advantages of adopting this high cost, low volume strategy. Since your price will be very low or will be the lowest in the market, you can have a protection against the competition. And when your suppliers have a high bargaining power, it may not affect you very much since you have a huge market base, huge customer base. The cost of purchase, if the cost of purchase is little high, you can get it compensated by selling to a large number of customers. And third, you can also manage buyer's bargaining. Since in this market, there is no major differentiation among the products available, customers tend to bargain more. When you are already selling at the lowest price, the same product which is available with the other products available in the market, customers tend to buy the product at the rate at which you propose, since you are already offering at the lowest price. And this may also act as a barrier for new entrants to enter. Because when you are already a low-cost player, new player may think and he may find it difficult to match your price. And he may not feel that it may be a profitable venture. So he may escape or he may assist to enter into this market. While these are the advantages, there are also some risks involved in following this low-cost, high-volume strategy. Let us see what they are. Since this low-cost is not a very unique feature, your competitor can also offer their products at a lower cost. So, this may not be a long-lasting strategy. At the same time, since your focus is on reducing the cost of your product, you may not focus more on the needs and requirements of your target customers. Your sole motive will be on reducing the actual price rather than focusing on what your customer is requiring. Thirdly, generally there is a perception that low-cost products will be of poor quality. So it is very important to overcome that particular perception of people, because it may lead to poor sales volume, which is not expected, which is not your actual goal. And finally, when there is a technological shift happens, or when there some new technology comes in, your entire product may become obsolete, or your new technology may come in and reduce the price further, and if your competitor is adopting any particular technology and reducing the price drastically, then it may also affect you. So these are the risks involved in adopting this low cost, high volume strategy. Second strategy is having unique product features. So what is having unique product features? Your product will have a differentiated features that are demanded by the customers, but that features will not be available in the product of your competitors. Your product will have a unique future meeting a unique requirement of your target customers, but that unique requirement is not met by your competitors. To say an example, when Parley Agro introduced Fruity in 1985, they introduced Fruity in a Tetra Pak. Earlier, there was no Tetra Pak and all these soft drinks and cool drinks were offered in bottles. Since they were offered in bottles, customers have to return it back to the shop. They were not able to carry it wherever they go. They were not able to carry it during their tours, picnics, etc. They were not able to keep it in their homes. This Tetra Pak allowed them to take it wherever they want, store it in their house, and this offered a whole lot of benefits. This differentiation in terms of packaging made Fruity very popular, and this set a new trend in the packaging industry, especially in the soft drinks market. How to achieve this unique product feature strategy? It is very necessary to incorporate unique features. So these features should be of various natures. Let us see what they are. The features which you or offering, or the unique feature which your product has, should meet the needs of your customer. it should reduce the overall cost for the customer. What is reducing the overall cost for the customer? Let us say you are looking for a different service connection. You are going to a brand A. Brand A is offering your internet service connection at a lower cost, but you have to pay for your modem and router upfront. You have a separate cost, and it is a one-time cost, and you have to bear it. However, the monthly subscription is very lower. You go to brand B. Brand B is slightly has a higher price, but at the same time, they do not ask you to pay for the modem and router, but you have to pay a monthly rental for the modem and router, which again adds up the cost. Even though the price is slightly higher than the previous one, again you have to pay for the rental of the modem and router. The third case, the monthly subscription is even more higher, but you need not pay for the modem and router. When you compare all these three brands, the third brand, which offers only the monthly subscription without any cost for modem or router, even though its price is higher, the overall cost when compared to the brand A and B is lesser. The amount which you pay upfront for your modem and router, or the amount which you pay every month as a rent for modem and router, is still higher than the actual monthly subscription of the brand C, or the third brand. So here the overall cost for the customer is reduced, even though it seems that the customer is paying a slightly higher monthly subscription charges, the overall cost seems to be very less. So the features which you have should reduce the overall cost for the customer. Third, the features which you incorporate or the unique feature which your product has should increase the buyer's satisfaction. Unless and otherwise the buyer or customer is satisfied with the product feature, it is very necessary to last long in the market. And finally, the features which you add to your product should raise the or improve the or increase the performance of your product. So these are the parameters that you should keep in mind while incorporating new and unique features to your product. And the features which you add should also increase the status or prestige of the customer among their peers. So people generally like to have high prestige among their peers and society, and then the society and among their relatives. When they own something, they feel that it should enhance their status and prestige, and they should make others feel that they have made the right purchase, or they have made a very good purchase or something like that. So the features which you have should be able to enhance the status and prestige of your customers. So here are the prerequisites to adopt this unique product feature strategy. When the market is filled with standardized products without any major differentiation, you can find out a very unique need of the customers that are not met by the existing products. You can identify that particular need and introduce a feature in your product to satisfy that particular need of your customers. And the customer's needs are too diversified for a standardized product. When customer's needs are, or when customers have various needs, but they have only a standardized product to satisfy their need, it is very necessary, or it is very easy to identify one particular need of the customer and introduce a feature that is satisfying the particular need of the customer. And when customers are ready to pay a premium for the differentiation, it is easy to adapt this unique product differentiation strategy. There might be a particular problem which the customer really wants to get rid of, but there is no any product to solve that particular problem. There is only standard products which do not have any future to solve that particular problem. When you offer a future in a product that solves that big problem of the customers should be ready to pay a premium for that. If you have that kind of problem in the market or that kind of solution, then it becomes easy to introduce this strategy. And when it is easy to develop a brand loyalty because of a unique future that your product has, it is very easy to introduce this unique product feature in your product. And because of the product differentiation and the premium pricing, your market share should increase. It should not decrease. If you can increase the market share in spite of having a premium pricing, then you can definitely go for or definitely adopt this strategy. And what are the advantages of adopting this unique product feature strategy? It increases brand loyalty because you will be the only product which has that particular feature. So your brand loyalty gets increased naturally. And since we have the product which offers a unique feature which no other product in the market has, you can easily beat the competition. And you can also manage the bargaining power of the suppliers. When your suppliers have a higher bargaining power, you can manage that with your loyal customer base. Since you have loyal customer base, you will have a regular movement of your product and regular purchase of your product. So you can manage with the cash flow, and also you can bargain with your suppliers that say, I have a huge customer base and I can sell so much of volume, so I will be buying this much raw materials from you, so we can offer it at a better price. You can bargain with your suppliers also, and you can also bargain with your customers. When they ask for a lower price, you can say, this has a unique feature and this solves this particular need of yours and which is not available in any other product available in the market, so this is priced at a premium. So you can manage the bargaining power of the customers as well. And since we have a unique future and we have a loyal customer base, new entrants may not be able to give you a stiff challenge unless they offer a differentiated product that solves a unique problem of your target customers, or they solve the same problem which you are addressing in a much better way. There are lots of risks involved in adopting this strategy. Some of the competitor may imitate what exactly you are doing, and sometimes the feature which you think is different from other products and it solves a particular need of the customer, but actually customers may not think so, or actually it may not solve the need of the customer. So it may also happen. And in some cases, due to premium pricing, your total number of customers may come down. Even though you may have a loyal customer base, it may be a very small numbers. So it is, if you are looking at a little more volumes, you should not focus on a very narrow niche. And if you narrow down too much, you cannot have a huge sales volume, and that is another risk involved. And if you are not communicating properly the product features which your product has and the reason behind the premium pricing, then people may not understand why your product is priced at a premium and they may not buy from you. So these are the risks involved. So These are the two things which you saw, basically two strategies. One is to follow low cost and high volume, and second is to have unique product feature. And third is a blue ocean strategy. Blue ocean strategy is something which makes your product to move into a space where there is no competition at all. It is not where to beat competition actually. It is moving to a market space where there is no competition at all. Why it is called blue ocean strategy? Consider a ocean where there are a lot of fishes available and a shark comes there. The shark usually eats smaller fishes. The shark happily eats the smaller fishes and it lives happily there. And another shark comes that way and sees there are a lot of fishes available and only one particular shark is here. That also starts feeding on the fishes available. Likewise, seeing these two sharks, many other sharks come, and finally there will be a lot of sharks fighting for a very few fishes, and there will be a competition among the sharks leading to a bloody ocean. So that ocean becomes red, and that is called red ocean, where there is a huge competition. So one of the sharks move to a different ocean where there is no competition and there are a lot of fishes. So this ocean is still blue, because and since there is no competition, or since the shark has moved to a new market, new place, it is able to acquire the market share and able to meet the needs of that particular market. Since there is no bloodshed, it is called blue ocean. So blue ocean is moving to a market space where there is no competition. You go there, make build your market space, increase your market, you create a market for yourselves and be a market leader and have a name for yourselves before someone else comes. Even if someone else comes, you will be still the leader and you create a position for yourself. This is called blue ocean strategy, and we will see more about blue ocean strategy in a different video. I hope you had a fair idea about this low cost, high volume strategy and unique product feature strategy, and a basic idea about blue ocean strategy. I hope this will be helpful and that you can implement in your business. If you have any clarifications or if you have any doubts, please feel free to drop it in the comment box. I'll be happy to answer them. If you have any other feedback, please leave it in the comment box. I will be happy to read them and improve myself. If you need a video on any specific topic, please feel free to let me know. I'll be making a video on that. Please do share it with your business community, other entrepreneurs and businessmen for whom this will be useful. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, please do subscribe and press the bell icon for instant notifications. Please do like, comment and share. I'll meet you in another video. Till then, this is Boniface signing off. Cheers. Bye.